Is it? Here you are, ma'am.
Quite the ball, Mr. President.
I thought it might be a bit unseemly given the circumstances.
Eisenhower had them. So did Lincoln during the Civil War. People need to celebrate, even in the worst of times.
Seeing as the James is in dry dock for months, well, I'm gonna need you here as Chief of Naval Operations.
That's a pretty big job, sir.
Don't forget, I was number 12. Fly your family out. They'll settle here. There'll be plenty to do. I'm already hearing from the Northeast about more lawlessness, factions of warlords fighting over big cities, battles over natural resources in the Southwest, South America. They're even in worse shape than us. We have a nation to build and a world to repair. And there's no one I trust more.
Sounds like an order.
It is. Tonight, we rest and enjoy our success. Tomorrow, the fight for America and the rest of the world begins.
It was Christmas Eve. We're doing this anti-piracy mission off the coast of Somalia.
We come across this poor Hungarian freighter.
Engine problems, 50-person crew, nowhere to go. Frankie and I were running point. Meanwhile, back on our ship, our mail arrives from home, presents from our families. Frankie turns to me and he says, "What about the Hungarians? Don't they get a Christmas?" And I'm like, "Frankie, like, this is a hostile situation." But he's not hearing it, not for a second. 30 minutes later, our helo is hovering over that Hungarian ship. Frankie is fast roping down, dressed as Santa Claus.
Oh, my God. Handing out presents to that entire crew.
Wow. Wow, that is awesome.
That was Frankie Benz.
To Frankie Benz.
Frankie Benz.
Frankie Benz.
Benzo.
Benzo.
Benzo. Benzo.
It's Chung.
To Lynn.
To Maya. Smith.
To Bertram. To Barker.
To Cassetti.
To Cody.
To Beavis.
To Beavis.
You're here.
You're here.
You're here.
You're here.